Beneath the tropic skies of Hilo stands. Oh. Oh.
Here we all stand. Well, let me rephrase that. Here I am, and there you are, most likely watching from the comfort of your own home. Sure, we're celebrating this year with yet another virtual graduation, but we're making it one to remember. Since everything is essentially virtual nowadays, I'd say it's quite easy to visualize a sea of proud family members, teachers, and peers sitting before me. But, of course, that's not the case.
Nothing about this year has been conventional. From our last first day to our final homecoming to today, as I look into the lens of a camera rather than the eyes of my classmates. It's been some time since we've seen each other. And no, staring at people's icons in the Zoom meeting doesn't count.
A while ago, we might have envisioned a traditional Hilo High School graduation, complete with the seas of people and the blaring air horns. The whole shebang. But things didn't turn out the way we expected. Or maybe it was how we expected, but not quite the way we hoped. On the bright side, at least we don't have to worry about parking.
You see, the virtual aspect of it all is exactly what makes our graduating class one of the most unique in the history of Hilo High School. We are the first ever senior class to have to endure a whole year of virtual learning. And although we didn't have the constant pressure of teachers literally standing right behind as we did our work, we managed to pull through. Our achievements were not made by chance.
As the world began to close, our class opened up the book of possibilities. Instead of thinking, I can't do this, we questioned, how can we do this? This is a place for the quizzical, and one thing is certain. Wondering and wandering go hand in hand. There's a raging fire within each and every one of us, burning steadfast and strong. It's fueled by our virtue, our passions, our endurance, and our community.
From start to finish, it was our own self-motivation and drive that got us through the year. In a way, our class is kind of like a pua-collet plant, a little prickly, resilient, and incredibly stubborn. Growing on the slopes of the mana, the pua-collet plant thrives with the smallest amounts of water, adorning sharp prickles on its stems, leaves, and seeds. From this plant also blooms a radiant white flower, delicate and rare, the ultimate portrayal of the strength and perseverance of the pua-collet. It's tolerant of drought and is the first to be seen after a fire. This class, our class, is the same. We survived the unthinkable and have pushed forward regardless.
We grew towards the sky even when placed in rough, undesirable soil. Our class bloomed together, showcasing our talents and resilience to the world. We are not meant to blend into the landscape, but to make our presence known to the world. We are both the thorns and the blossom, flourishing in some of the most unlikely circumstances and bringing forward the proof of our battles hard fought. These battles, both physically and mentally, have shaped the people we have become, as well as gave meaning to us as a class.
The road leading up to this day was filled with many obstacles. But you want to know what? We all made it. That shy freshman that hoped to go to a prestigious university recently committed to an Ivy League school. That athletic freshman that hoped to take their game to the next level just recently accepted an athletic scholarship to play at the collegiate level. That confused freshman that was unsure of what the future had in store just recently figured out what they will be pursuing for the next 4 years. We're no longer the new and hopeful rookies on campus. We're the students that are finally set to unrelentlessly pursue our goals, ready to turn our hopes and dreams into reality.
Still, we remember where we come from and all that we faced along the way, both the good and the bad, and everything in between. And there is something infinitely beautiful about the journey. Our lives are a mosaic of the times we share with one another, in the place our hearts will always call home. Here, we get to create memories to treasure forever and carve out the spaces for ourselves in the lives of others. These are things to cherish, these moments where we can share laughter and tears and accomplishments and struggles with the people we care about. And with these people, we've also learned how to support one another. When there is someone in need, we rally behind them, pushing them forward until they are running on their own. Then, we run alongside them.
Now, we could go on to give some advice we've gathered throughout our high school career, but here's the thing. We don't have it all figured out, and that's how life is. Sometimes you just have to wing it, kind of like those essays we knew we had to write but didn't realize were due so soon. But something we have learned is that the importance lies in how we continue to move forward and how we find strength in both ourselves and in the people around us. We've made it this far, and now we keep going. Our setbacks, our successes, in whatever form they may be, they belong to us, and it's a gift I would never exchange.
Looking back on our first days of high school is a testament to that. I think we all can remember our first day with everyone at school. The chaos of our first lot and those feelings of instability and vulnerability as we stepped out into a much larger world than the one we have grown used to. At the start, we didn't know what to expect, but little by little, we found a home in the halls of Hilo High. We might not be aware of it all the time, but we have grown and changed in ways we could have never imagined together.
And these past 3 years are only the beginning. We're constantly in the process of learning something new, and life is going to surprise us. But every moment we experience is an opportunity. It's a chance to discover something about ourselves, to put something good out into the world, to make change and be changed. Forever questing, forever questioning, and forever curious.
There is a spark in each and every one of us, the things our dreams are composed of, that gets us out of bed in the morning and inspires us in day-to-day life. Maybe it's science or art or sports. Maybe it's the dream of becoming an engineer, a world-class athlete, or an award-winning scientist. Maybe it's the dream of just doing something good in the world, serving our country and community, being the best version of yourself, and going after the things you love. Each of these dreams is an integral part of the world we get to help build.
Without leaders, servicemen, and tradesmen, we fall into chaos. Without artists, we live hollow lives. Without scientists, we fail to understand our world, our universe. Without each of these billions of little pieces, there is no future in which we are alive, in every sense of the word. Whichever paths we choose to follow, none will be more or less important than the next. We are all crucial to this world, not just following our dreams, but working towards them and giving our all in the name of creating something good, something like hope.
We are the future of this world, and judging by the group of students I'm graduating with today, I can proudly say that the future is bright. We are the athletes, scholars, and artists, the future healthcare professionals, scientists, and writers, the innovators, the creators, and the future educators, the future leaders, groundbreakers, and history makers. I know I've missed a lot of career paths here, so feel free to say it now, to yourself, out loud, scream it at the top of your lungs. The point still stands. We are everything beyond and everything in between. Our potential is endless, both in who we are now and who we can become. With this, we march forward and find our places, pushing the limits and creating the same hope in the world that our community instilled in us.
So at last, here we stand, with everyone we've grown with, everyone who has built us up, and at the close of this chapter, we say thank you. Thank you to our friends and families who have loved and supported us unconditionally and gave our souls a home. Thank you to the teachers, staff, and administration who made sure our voices were heard. Thanks to the unofficial emotional support animals for keeping us sane, and our older siblings who taught us what not to do in high school.
To my fellow classmates, take a moment to thank yourselves for the tremendous amount of work that you all put in up until this point. Do not forget that at the end of the day, it will always be up to you to walk yourself across that finish line.
We may come from a small town, but we are not afraid. In our fearlessness, we take the first steps towards being an inspiration. Not only will we prove that anyone can succeed, no matter their background, we will proudly show our Hawaiian roots. We will share our traditions, appreciation of the land, and the importance of Ohana with the rest of the world.
Our lives are only just beginning. The ink in our books still fresh as we prepare to turn the page. But it's important to remember to slow down every once in a while. Years have passed and will pass in the blink of an eye. As much as we may want to sprint to the end sometimes, there are countless moments to be enjoyed along the way. The beauty in our lives comes not through our final destination, but the battles we fought and the people we fought them with.
We are closing this door so that we can open others. This chapter is just the start. But we have shown that our voices can and will be heard. In the depths of the unknown, we turn to one another and search within ourselves for the strength, power, and most of all, hope that will nourish us in the days ahead. As we leave Hilo High, we enter our journey of self-discovery and fulfillment.
Vahi a ka mea hano hano o ke aloha aina, o yo sepa, ko ho'oluhi, na vahi o kalani opu. Ua hele aku au me ka mana o pa'a. Ua paio aku au me ka mana o koa. Ua lana kila aku au me ka mana o pono. A ua makaukau au me ka mana o vivo ole. E na ohana, na kā ko'o, a me na hoa puka kula o ka makaiki iwa kālua ko makahi. Ua pai ko mako va'a, ua ma'ona ko opu i ka momona ka aina, a ke lei ha'aheo nei i ka leo ka lana kila ma ka uma uma. Ma o ka umia ana i ka hanu, mana vāpa'a kiki, i ho'i ke oia i oai ke ano pa'a mau o mako. Ma o ka ho'oko ana i na ha'avina, a me ke kulia loka hi mau, i paio ai mako me ka mana o koa. Ma o ko mako ano ha'aha'a a ho'ihi, i kulumai ko mako ano he kanaka pono, a ma o ko mako ano vivo ole mau, e ola mau ke ano he vaikini o ke kula ki e ki e o hilo, a ke ano he aloha aina o ka lāhui Hawaii. Ola naivi. I travel steadfast, I fight with bravery, I win with righteousness, and I am fearlessly ready for anything. These famous words said by a celebrated Hawaiian patriot, Joseph Koho'oluhi, na vahi o kalani opu'u, is a true testimony to our journey as students of Hilo High School.
To the families, teachers, supporters, and my fellow classmates of the class of 2021, our canoe has landed, our stomachs filled from the delicacies of the land, and we proudly adorn the garlands of victory on our chest. As we patiently endure these struggling times, we have proven our steadfast attitude, completing each assignment to the best of our ability and bravely working together has led us to great achievements. Loyalty and honor are qualities we all possess as we proudly carry ourselves with humility and righteousness. And being fearlessly prepared will forever live on in each of us as a Hilo High Viking and as a virtuous person of Hawaii.